Thank you again for this day. And just like you showed your presence on the day of Pentecost, Father God, help all of us to catch on fire. In 2018, dear God, with a fresh anointing. Father God, help all of us to trust you. And now, Father God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will move in a mighty way, that you will open our ears to hear and our hearts to receive your word. Thank you now for the move of the Holy Spirit. Come now, Lord Jesus. It is thy servant's prayer. In Jesus' name I pray and give you thanks. Amen. What makes the difference? Amen. We all experience frustrations, disappointments, and setbacks in life. And if we have not, as the songwriter said, just keep on living. And since we all will experience these things, we need to know what allows us to go through. We need to know what gives us the strength, Canaan. We need to know what gives us comfort in the midst of grief. We need to know, glory be to God, even when we lose someone close to us, how we're able to get through our storms. When we experience heartache after heartache, and we're still able to smile and say, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Can I get a witness? When we experience being mistreated, persecuted, ostracized, and still be able to press on the higher ground, somebody ought to say thank you. Persons may not understand how we are enduring. Persons may not understand how we're able to keep it all together and keep on getting back up. Can I get a witness this morning? Persons may not understand how we're even able to hold on in the midst of our fiery furnace. Anybody been there before? But I stop by to remind us on this day of Pentecost that, glory be to God, we have to know what really makes the difference. Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. I want you to know it's not our prestigious last name. It is not our bank account. It is not our holier-than-thou attitude. It is not our degrees in front or behind our names. It is not our accolades or even our positions in the church. It is not our job titles for our secular world. It is the Holy Spirit that makes the difference. Somebody ought to give the Lord some praise. It is the Holy Spirit that continues to shine in our lives. It is the Holy Spirit that keeps reminding us that God has our backs. Somebody ought to tell the Lord thank you this morning. It is the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us that God is in control. Somebody ought to say thank you. It is the Holy Spirit that reminds us, even in the midst of grief, that God is in control and God will take care of us. That God is our comforter. Sometimes we get it twisted, but we gotta know who God is. It is the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us, Reverend Geddes, that even in the midst of needing direction, that God is our advocate. And how many of you know God is working it out on our behalf? Amen. Somebody ought to say thank you. It is the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us that even when we are faced with our fiery furnaces, that God has a way of delivering us from the hands of the enemy. It is the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us that when we're in the midst of our fiery furnace, that God is our protector. Anybody in Canaan knows that this morning? If you do, you ought to say thank you. Amen. Say it like you mean it. Let the Lord thank you. to remind us, even in the darkest days, when our days seem to be long, that God will never leave us nor forsake us. I need a witness in here this morning. It is the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us that even in the midst of death, God is able to speak new life. It's the Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us, Canaan, that God is our refuge, that God is our strength, that God is our ever-present help. It's the Holy Spirit that continues to remind us that the Lord God Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. My beloved friends, the Holy Spirit, it really makes the difference in our lives. Somebody ought to say thank you. See, I remember in my own life, when I was confronted with an issue, I had just finished preaching, and the Holy Spirit moved in a mighty way, Brother King, and during the service. But after the benediction was over, how many of you know Satan has a way of raising his ugly head? Can I get a witness? The convener of the meeting was downright mean and nasty and wanted decisions to fall her way. Anybody been there before? And so as I was getting ready to open my mouth, because the flesh told me that's what I needed to do. Anybody been there? Hallelujah. The Lord locked my jaw. And the Lord said, don't worry about this, my son. I got this. Somebody ought to say thank you. Immediately, there was a calmness over me. There was a peace that came over me. Oh, and my disappointment turned into joy. All because God said, I got this. Anybody knows what I'm talking about? You got to learn how to listen to the Holy Spirit and realize it's not about us, but it's about Jesus. As much as my human side wanted to retaliate, God said, no, I got this. Because I listened to the Holy Spirit and acknowledged the presence of God. How many of you know I'm proud to say God made everything all right? Anybody that came here ever been there before? See, God had a way for me to be the God of heaven. It's everything that was decided on Sunday. How many of you know, Sister Dorothy, by Wednesday, God turned it around? I need somebody who knows what I'm talking about. Somebody ought to say thank you.
Tell your neighbor, let go of your flesh and learn how to let the Holy Spirit lead you.
Come with me, hallelujah. When we lean to our own understanding, we'll fail every time. When we want our way all the time, glory be to God, it's not always what God desires. But we got to learn how to be obedient to the voice of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, my beloved friends. It made a difference not only then, but I'm so glad it makes the difference now. So 3 points and I'm out of the way this morning. The Holy Spirit makes a difference in our personal lives, in our relationships, and in our churches. Yes, the Holy Spirit makes a difference in our personal lives. See, the Holy Spirit comes in and it cleans us up. Do I have a witness in here this morning? Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I know you love Comet. I know you may even love Clorox and Ajax. But when, glory be to God, we call on the name of Jesus and the Holy Spirit comes in, how many of you know God is able to clean us up? The Holy Spirit is our cleaning agent. But not only is the Holy Spirit a cleaning agent, anybody knows that the Holy Spirit is a convictor of the soul. Anybody ever done wrong and you thought nobody else knew about it? Amen. Don't get quiet on me. You thought nobody knew what you said. You thought nobody knew where you had been. Anybody been there before? You thought nobody knew what you said about that other person. Can I get a witness? Hallelujah. But a lot of times we want to shut it off. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, you got to give leeway to the Holy Spirit. See, it's the Holy Spirit that gives us power. Some folk, glory be to God, want all the power they can get in an earth around. But when we have the power of the Holy Spirit, how many of us realize that power that God gives us compares to none other? Can I get a witness? When we have the power of the Holy Spirit in our personal lives, the Bible makes it clear that we're able to lay hands on those that are sick, and the sick will recover. When we have the power of the Holy Spirit, we can trample on snakes and scorpions. When we have the Holy Spirit, no devil in hell can stop us. We have power to overcome the enemy. Can I get a witness in here this morning? God, if like you hadn't been through anything, but when you know who God is, you can speak to the enemy and say, get on out of my way. My beloved friends, thank you, God. According to God's holy word, nothing will harm us. Can I get a witness? It is the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit, that makes a difference in our personal lives. Secondly, the Holy Spirit makes a difference in our relationships. Sometimes we run across some rough folk. Anybody been there before? Sometimes we run up against some giants. Sometimes we run up against some persons that make it so hard for us to stay focused. Sometimes we run up against persons that make our lives a living hell. Amen. Don't get quiet. Sometimes we run up against those persons that will try us on every level. But how many of you know when we have the Holy Spirit, it'll make a difference in how we love. It'll make a difference in how we're able to look that person in the eye and say, that's all right, you may not agree with me, but guess what, I love you anyhow. Can I get a witness? When you got the Holy Spirit, you're able to walk with another person. Even though that married person may not be going in the same direction all the time, but the Holy Spirit will help you to love beyond measure. It'll make a difference even in how we serve. Amen. Some of us are just serving. Amen. I want to be president of this, president of that. Hallelujah. Amen. You're quiet on me, but that's all right. But how many of you know when we got the Holy Spirit, we will really serve? Somebody ought to say thank you. But we gotta learn, the Holy Spirit makes the difference. It'll make the difference in how we get along with others on our ministry teams. It'll make a difference in how we work together as a church to be the church that God is calling us to be. I'm gonna say that again. It'll make a difference in how we work together as a church to be the church that God is calling us to be. Barrett, what are you talking about? Too many of us just want to come to church. Yellow. Amen. That's all right. There's a difference in coming to church and being the church. Can I get a witness? It's all right. See, on this day of Pentecost, Brother Davis, the power of the Holy Spirit, it brought the Galileans, the Elamites, the residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Persia, Pam- from. But how many of you know when the Holy Spirit, when the Holy Spirit brings us together, it is beyond color. It is beyond denominational lines. It is beyond all of the barriers that we put in place. And the Bible says when they came together, they started speaking in an unknown language as the Holy Spirit gave utterance. A lot of persons thought they were drunk. Some thought they had cognac. Some thought they had bull. Some thought, glory be to God, they had Michelob. Amen. Some thought they had, glory be to God, white lightning. Can I get a witness? But they made it clear it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. Can I get a witness? How many of you know when the Holy Spirit shows up, people will not understand. It's all right. It's all right. Because it'll be God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. At work. Somebody ought to say thank you. It's the Holy Spirit that draws us together. It is the Holy Spirit that binds all of us together. We know even yesterday, as the royal wedding was being performed, persons criticized from sun up to sun down. But I'm a firm believer. As we know, it was the power of love. But I firmly believe it was the Holy Spirit also at work in the life of the royal couple. Amen. Hallelujah. Reminding all of us there is yet work to be done. Finally, the Holy Spirit makes a difference in the church. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor. That's a neighbor. The Holy Spirit makes a difference in our church. Too many persons in our churches are operating on their own accord. Too many persons in our churches are trying to fulfill their own selfish desires. Too many persons in our churches all over this world are power hungry. Too many persons in our churches are operating out of selfish ambitions. Too many persons are just coming to church rather than being the church. Too many persons are just coming to church rather than coming to worship. Go through too much in a week to just show up for church. Anybody been there before? Maybe you don't understand. See, Monday through Sunday, we all go through. And see, Brother Chisholm, I just don't want to show up to church on Sunday. But when I come into the presence of God, when I come in the presence of the Holy Spirit, I want to feel like I've been in touch with God. Anybody knows what I'm talking about? I want to feel like everything I gave God, God has already worked out. My friends, when we allow the Holy Spirit to come in, it will fuel us. When we allow the Holy Spirit to empower us, when we allow the Holy Spirit to use us for the glory of God, church will no longer be church. Amen.
Amen.
But hallelujah. Church will turn into worship. And our worship will turn into praise. When we allow the Holy Spirit to use us for the glory of God, church, it'll make a difference. Lives will be transformed. Hearts will be convicted. Souls will be delivered. Hallelujah. People will cry out, "What must I do, Lord, them on this day of Pentecost. There was an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Some thought they were drunk with wine. But it was made clear, no, they're not drunk as you suppose. But they are filled with the Holy Spirit. In the last days, his word says, my Holy Spirit will be poured upon all flesh. I don't know about you this morning, but I'm so glad that I know the Holy Spirit makes all the difference in the world. Can I get a witness? So realize today, the Holy Spirit can make a difference in our personal lives, in the way we love one another, and even in the way we grow as a church. But we gotta learn how to seek the Lord. Now somebody is saying, well, what is all of this about? I just want to remind all of us, on the day of Pentecost, as they were in the upper room, hallelujah, they all came together on one accord. Hallelujah. There were no big eyes or little ears, but according to the word, everybody came together. Anybody knows what I'm talking about? How many of you know when we come together, we'll see God moving? Can I get a witness? When we come together and allow the Holy Spirit to direct us, don't you know, glory be to God, God will show up and God will perform miracles in our lives. Can I get a witness? But not only in our lives, but God is able to perform miracles in our churches and in our relationships. But we got to learn how to tap in to the true and living source. So what makes the difference? It is the Holy Spirit that makes the difference in our lives. And it is my prayer that not only will Canaan catch on fire and burn with the Holy Spirit, but it's my prayer that all of God's churches will catch on fire and burn like the day of Pentecost. In Jesus' name. The Holy Spirit makes the difference. Come on and give the Lord some bread. Come on and bless the Lord. Everybody who's able to stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. It makes the difference. And the Holy Spirit leads you today. It's not a time for chit-chat. But I just want you just to encourage somebody to sanctuary. And it's not negative, but it's an encouragement. Yeah. Tell somebody else the Holy Spirit leads you. Say it's time to catch on fire. As the Holy Spirit gives you utterance, tell somebody it's time to catch on fire.